bodied up to the air, to the earth, to the atmosphere. Light it up, everything is right here. Cause I have waited forever, 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 forever for this. Cause I have waited forever, 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 forever for this. So many coins that I
got another game to beat. Hi, hey, howdy, hello. How we doing? We did a short stream a little bit ago. Got in and out real quick. Had some highlights, had some lowlights, had a little bit of fun. Scratched an itch that I've had for a while. But now to the important stuff. Now to the important stuff. We got another half of a game to beat. And that is Riku's side of Chain of Memories. Yeah, I did a short and sweet stream earlier. I played PUBG because I only had an hour. So, yeah. Like I said, right now, we got to beat this, dude. Woo-wee! So, let's just jump right into it. Start game is Riku. Obviously, we're doing proud mode. Keep the vibration on. I didn't even realize it last time. Hear it. Let's go. We kicked major ass last night. Time to kick some more major ash.
Where am I?
Stay asleep.
Who's there?
You should remain asleep. Here, between light and dark.
Between what? The king! Where's the king? Together we close the door to darkness. After that?
You came drifting here by yourself. You did not have the strength to overcome the darkness. Or maybe you were close to it.
As if I'm some kind of demon.
Turn from the light. Shut your eyes. Here, blanketed by the darkness, sleep is safety. Sleep is eternal. But
oh, what's this?
It is a door to the truth. Take it and your sleep ends as you take the first step toward the truth. But know this, the truth will bring you pain. Will you still go? There is no return to the security of sleep.
This seemed like a boring place to take a nap anyway.
That was very well said, Riku.
Nice, dude. Boring part. He's not edgy. Gasp. Yeah, dude, I went over his fishing pants when I first started Kingdom Hearts 1, because I thought they were part of his pants. I was like, this is the weirdest design for a character model I've ever seen. But nope, they're just add-ons to pants, so your real pants don't get wet. I had no idea. That was even a thing. I thought you fished on boats like a regular person. No, I forgot I don't have glide anymore. Oh, dude, his fucking dodge is sick. His dodge is fucking awesome. Alright. So, I got a little, confession to make. I did not play Riku's story when I played Chain of Memories. Not a one time. I was like, I know what happens. I don't need to play it. He has normal pants under them. Yep. He replaces them when he gets his cool suit in Kingdom Hearts 3. I got his Funko Pop right here. He's got like checkerboards and shit on it. He's got a cool jacket. Aw, man. This is Hollow Bastion. What you see is not real. It's the world of your memory. My memory? The things you remember from your time at Maleficent's castle became a card, and that card made this world. You've seen everything here before, haven't you? Yeah. So what now? Am I going to learn something? Maybe meet someone? You would meet the people in your memories. Ordinarily. I thought there'd be more. What does that mean? Hey, I'm asking you a question. He's gone. Fine. But it better be you I run across next, voice. Can't change the decks and you kind of play the game. He becomes like a punk when he grows up, clothing-wise. Dude, it's sick. I like his jacket. Thor's got a cool jacket, too. How are you supposed to fly fish without waters or salmon fishing in a river? Dude, that's what boats are for. I should have looked at his deck beforehand.
Take this.
Can he do anything cool?
Like it?
Oh, you could just recharge? That's overpowered.
Take this.
What the fuck? Attack boost? Darkness boost? Yeah, this is all new to me. Used to do that shit, it's a blast. Fuck boats. No, boats are awesome. Look how glidey I am. Holy shit. Or floaty, rather. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, no, I missed every single one. That's why I could just get them back. Ow, stop it. I thought I'd kill them both.
Like it?
Stupid. Okay. Dude, that's so overpowered. You don't have to charge it up at all? Yeah. Easy peasy. Waters, it's waders? Oh, like you're wading through water? Okay. I don't know, dude. I'm from the city. We don't fish down there. We go to the market. Like a real American. Our river here is poisonous. If you fish there, you'll die. Oh no, we gotta kill this thing. No, my cool boost, or dodge rather. But you can't change his deck? Oh, fuck.
Take this.
I mean, that's fine if it works well, right?
Like it.
Do it.
Take this.
Look at that, dude, that's great. God damn it. You just get all your cards back like that. Nice. God. I hate this enemy. Nice job, Riku. Really There we go. It's spelt. Yeah, it's waters without it. Without a T, so you say waters instead of water. Waters. Instead of water. Waters. You can't change his deck. Are there like cool things you can do with it though? Like, are there slates that I'm just not doing? I'm just kind of mindlessly pressing triangle.
Like it.
Like it. Dude, why couldn't Sora have something like that?
Take this.
Where you get your cards back? That's fucking awesome. Yeah. Oh, shit. Oops. I love his dodge. You just get preset decks. Yeah, I knew your decks were set. I knew that was one of the memes. I missed. No. There we go. And I think, what is it? Is it, Wonderland? Or not Wonderland. What's, Alice in Wonderland, yeah. I'm thinking it never, yeah. Isn't Wonderland, like, super tough? Like, the cards they give you, really bad. I feel like I remember reading that somewhere. Like it! Like, if I just get freaking slates, I'll be fine. I love this fucking dodge. I mean, listen, the less time I have to spend building a deck to get me through this fucking playthrough, the better.
Take this.
Yeah. God damn it.
Yeah. Like it.
Like it.
Take this.
Go. Oh my god. What a fucking waste of time. I'm assuming that's what, like, the darkness thing is. Like, it's saying level up Riku's darkness. Yeah, right there. I'm just gonna keep doing his attack. Why wouldn't I do his attack? Gee, he's so floaty, though. Jesus. Let's just keep doing this so we level up some more and more. Stop it, let me attack you from the back. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. That worked out. That also worked out, kind of. Do I have a fruit fly just flying around me? It's kind of pissing me off. There's no reason to. My house is completely clean. I cleaned it today, in fact. I don't know why there's a fruit fly. There's no food anywhere near me. But it just won't go away. Ah, god damn it. I want to die. Get the fuck away. It's your fault. My favorite part about Riku is when he attacks someone with his pointy sword and he screams, "Like it." Yeah, like that. Bomb, dude. Like it. Dirty house. It's not. I spent all day today cleaning it because I didn't go to work today. M'lady's car had issues with it. So I spent all day at the shop with it, and then when it was at the shop, at home cleaning. I didn't know when I'd have to leave. My favorite part too is that it stuns him. That's pretty cool. But it worked out though, because when I fucking work, I do not have the energy to do anything. Both my works are super intensive. Yeah. Aw. Super intensive.
Take this.
No, why did it only kill the one?
Like it. Yeah. Take this.
I'll just mindlessly go through this dude and talk.
Like it.
I'll talk about how I fucking choked the shit out of that last fight in PUBG earlier today. Do you really not like PUBG, Hitman? I love it. What don't you like about it? Oh, you don't like BRs, do you? That's your you don't like BRs, that's what it is. That's fine.
Take this.
There's a company coming out with a magic BR. Oh man, I'm pumped for that. It's kind of like the same art style as Fortnite. Yeah, I just like the game type. What don't you like about it? Curious. Do you like FP? Like, do you like shooters? Is that what you don't like? Is you don't like shooters? I'm curious. No, I don't play inverted. Magic sounds fun. Yeah, it's oh my god, what's it called? Somebody donated it to Doc. And he watched it. It's like Spellbound or something like that. It's really interesting. It looks fucking badass. It's kind of like if Realm Royale didn't blow Wiener. Like you can combo, so like you have your elemental, so you have earth, you have fire, you have wind, you have electric. I like shooters. Hold on. I don't like time before fights. I know I'm not like attacking you. I'm just curious what you don't like about it. I like hearing differing opinions. Because it's so popular right now, it seems like everyone's on the VR train, so I like hearing people disagree with it. Interesting to me. Don't like time before fights? Yeah. I get that. I think with, like our last game we played earlier today, I think I went like 4 minutes without a fight. Jelly was there. I went forever without fighting someone. It worked out because we killed two squads. No need to bully me. I'm not bullying.
Take this.
I just want to know, dude. I want to know your opinion.
Take this. Like it.
Like it.
Take this.
Oh yeah, tell me you like it. I should do this before the slate. And have that filling up as I'm using the slate.
Like it.
That'd be the smart move. No, I like hearing differing opinions on everything. And, someone who doesn't like BRs is definitely a differing opinion in this day and age.
Take this.
So it's cool to hear, for me, at least. Cause like, what I'll usually hear is like, oh man, I hate Fortnite, but I love Blackout, or I love PUBG, but fuck Rings of Elysium, which had a really good update today, by the way. I was actually going to play that. I was going to play Rings of Elysium, but I didn't have it installed. That was a bust. But yeah, I usually hear stuff like, you know, I like this one, but not that one. I like the companion. So someone who just doesn't like the game type, I like hearing. It's like hearing people back in the day who didn't like zombies when everybody played zombies. I loved knowing why. So I'm not putting myself into a bubble. Got a new map update. Yeah, so I was watching fucking Vis play it.
Take this.
It looks really, really good. The shooting's weird. The shooting mechanics are always weird in that game. But, the movement is what always drew me to that game. I fucking love the movement. And now they have a grappling hook that, like, in the snow map, they had hooks that you could, like, climb stuff with. You know, like an ice climber would, right? And then, but they have a grappling hook now where you can just aim it, and it's like Spider-Man almost, where just pew! It's awesome. And the BMX bike is sweet, and then the glider is just a glider. It's the same thing. But, oh man. I really wanted to play it. I really, really wanted to play it. but I didn't have enough time to install it. Otherwise, I would have. I did not like zombies after World at War. I was just burnt out on genre or ideas of just fighting zombies. Yeah, I'm the same way. We had a buddy, me and Jelly did, we had a buddy who was like super, super into zombies. He was more my friend, just because he went to my school, and that's when I still lived in the city. And he would like read strats and shit on how to like get the highest points. He's all about being on the leaderboards and everything. He was a cool guy. Wonder what he's up to now. But yeah, zombies, like, zombies was a good time killer, in my opinion. But I never loved zombies. I was never like, oh man, I can't wait to get home and play Call of Duty Zombies. Like, horde modes, if I wanted to play a horde mode, I'd just play fucking Left 4 Dead. A better version of zombies. Who are you talking about? I can't say his name, bro. His name was Andy. Andy. You remember him. I'm gonna get guarded. Yep. He was the kid who didn't get robbed when we were on the mics with him. I still tell that story every once in a while, by the way. I could say his name because I don't even remember his last name. Yeah. Like that Dave Chappelle sketch where, oh man, what's his name? Rick James is talking about, like, these guys are crazy. Like, I never put my feet on their couch. I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. Yeah, I put my feet on his couch. Oh, man. Shit, I wanted to attack the other guy. That's fine. Come over here. I tell it too, bro. He's a real estate agent now. The kid who got robbed. He's like a big-time real estate agent. Ah, damn it. I thought he'd come down. Very interesting life path. Goes from being held at gunpoint. Were you interviewed by the police? God damn it. I had a fucking detective come up to my mom's house from Westland. Yeah, it was. Exactly who it was. I do remember his last name. But yeah, I had a detective come from Westland and interview me. And I was scared fucking shitless because none of us called 911, so I thought we were gonna get like charged or something. Yeah. Not a one of us called 911. We're really good friends. Yeah, it was. That was a spooky time. That was my first time ever fucking. I'm friends with him on the book. What's the book? Facebook? Yeah, I don't have one of those. Do people still go on that? Facebook, you nerd. Nobody uses Facebook anymore. Nobody. The only people who use Facebook are freaking 47-year-old aunts who are trying to reclaim their youth. And Russians trying to sway elections. That's the only people who use Facebook anymore. And even then, it's kind of a crapshoot. Even the Russians are like, I don't know if we should use this right now. Where am I going? Right here. Fuck this room. I must be a Ruski. I just post memes. Dude, you gotta get... That's what Instagram and Twitter is for. And Reddit. The Gram, dude. Everything is just how I remember it. Even this room. It must be nice being back in your old bedroom. Think of all the memories. You again. Sorry, but these memories I could do without. Melissa gave me this room. So she did, and you lived here, tempted by the darkness she offered. What a shitty fucking bedroom. Look at that bed. That blanket's 2 feet long. Reddit has the best memes. All memes go through Reddit first, and then they just get cycled through everything. I've learned that. And then they get recycled through Reddit. You cast away your home, your friends, everything, but at least they gave you a nice room. Stop talking! He's so mad. And he's running out the door. And then they go to Tumblr. And then they go to fucking 4chan. Yeah, let's go this way. That's probably a gold room, eh? Go this way first. Yeah, let's do this one. 4chan. Isn't 4chan where hackers go? Nice fucking swing, dude. This guy has a hat bigger than Uganda, and you just swung right over top of him. Spencer Dinwiddie wouldn't do that, dude. He'd pull up over James Harden's face and nail a three. Spencer, Tracy, Spencer Dinwiddie, McGrady, Dinwiddie. This is so mindless. Yeah. This is really mindless. Did anybody watch the games last night? I bet Jelly did, or at least he saw highlights. Damn it. You talking about Black Me that is missing? A G? What? You just said a bunch of words that I don't comprehend together. You talking about Black Me as missing a G? What? Should have brought the old V-Gamers GT back. You know, I've tried to find that, Oh, James Harden, yeah. That's right! Oh my god, I didn't realize before! Oh my god. You gotta get a beard like him, dude. But about the V-Gamers thing, I've tried to find all that information before, and it's just lost to the masses, dude. I've legitimately tried finding that for the longest time, and it's just gone. But, yeah, when James Harden had 58 points and lost, or whatever it was, 48, something like that, to Spencer, Tracy, Spencer Dinwiddie, McGrady, Dinwiddie, the Great, Ex-Piston, by the way. Damn it, I was hoping to fucking kill him. Stop fucking following me. Who did we get? Oh, we got Cameron Barstow from the Dinwiddie trade. I don't remember my first gamer tag. I think you've been Cracker for as long as I've known you. You're Godowski 14 for a little bit when you first did a thing.
Take this. Like it. Take this.
But man, those games last night were fucking nuts. I was watching the highlights after my stream, and holy shit. Screw Dinwiddie, it's all about Jared Allen. Oh, you mean 2024? 20, what do you have? 2024 and like 6? Like, Jesus Christ. Are the Brooklyn Nets legit? Are they a real team? I don't know, are they? The fro and the stash equals legendary. Dinwiddie's got both of those. He just got a smaller fro like mine. I would say Dinwiddie's mustache is even better. It's more form-fitting. This guy is a fucking tank. Who, Riku? Yeah, he's literally the god character in every single game. Every single game. Allen rocks it better? I disagree. Let's do... that. Then when he got a porn stash? Exactly! You just won the argument for me. What are you trying to say here? Allen looks so silly, just Google him. Jared Allen? I know what he looks like. I'm saying Dinwiddie looks better. Like it? Even if I didn't know what he looked like, I knew what he looks like after last night. God, that fucking guard's annoying. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I just Googled him. Brooklyn, is Brooklyn legit? Are the Brooklyn Nets a legit basketball team right now? I don't know, I'm asking you guys. I'm not saying they're gonna make the fucking finals or nothing, but like, do teams actually have to try when they play the Brooklyn Nets now? Because Dinwiddie's been lighting people up all year. He's been like a more under the radar Derrick Rose. I don't watch basketball. Very good sport. Some would say the best. I think basketball is going to be the most popular sport in 20 years. Yeah. Ugh. Once people get tired of football, which is happening very quickly, Allen Crabbe ain't that hot anymore, and plus they have no bench. I mean, neither does LA. Look at LA, they're fucking trash when LeBron doesn't play. Did you see the stat today? LA, oh shit. LA has a worse, as a team, has a worse free throw shooting percentage than DeAndre Jordan. Than DeAndre Jordan. How do you have a worse free throw percentage than DeAndre Jordan? I understand he's gotten better this year, but he's still not like, lights out. Also, who's the guy shooting like 98% at the free throw line? It's a Raptor, ain't it? Or is it a Hawk? Someone's shooting like 98% from the free throw line. It's crazy. He's only missed one shot. He's taking like 98 of them. Every team is trash when they're missing their best player. That's not true at all. They're worse. But they're not. You don't go from being... Well... To reel back my argument, LeBron is shooting like 50-something percent. So he's part of that. LeBron is part of the shooting worse than DeAndre Jordan. What about the Bucks? The Bucks are legit. But they're not going to win a ring. Not yet. Definitely not this year. I love the Bucks. I think the Bucks are a fucking blast to watch. Did you see freaking Giannis Antetokounmpo? Freaking sodomized Marc Gasol last night? If you take Blake away from the Pistons, they have bottom seed in the East? Yeah. I'm not saying teams are the same when their best fucking player is gone. But a well-built team will do okay without their best player. Like, okay, let's take the top teams. Let's look at what is it? It's Milwaukee. It's Toronto. Golden State and Denver, right? Those are the top four teams. NBA standings. Yeah. So, if you took the Greek Freak away from Milwaukee, they're still probably a... Let's do a 10-game average. If you take the Greek Freak away, they're probably like a 7-3, 6-4 type team. The Raptors, if you took away Kawhi, they still have a ton of great players, but I'd say they're in the same range. 7-3, 6-4. Warriors, you saw with Curry. What, they went like 8-2 or something like that over a stretch? And Curry's much better than Durant. Don't even have that. I will kick your ass in that argument if you think Kevin Durant's better than Curry. And then the Nuggets. I don't even know who the Nuggets... Jokic? The Joker? Is that their best player? Or is it... what's his name? Their point guard. Murray. Yeah, I'd say Jokic is their best player. You think Jamal Murray is better than Jokic? You think Jamal Murray is better than Jokic? Wrong. 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 You're wrong. You are wrong. There's no way. I really hate Curry. I love Curry, dude. He's so fun to watch. That flourish last night was incredible. That was incredible. Does he run like a ninja? Hold on. I need to get into a fight. Curry was the best thing to happen to the NBA.
Like it.
He's trash. He's trash. How?
Take this.
He's completely
like
changed how the game is played. One player,
take
best
this.
Point guard in the league equals John Wall. You're high. You're high. You are high if you think John Wall is the best point guard. John Wall is probably the fourth or fifth because he's a terrible locker room. For a point guard, you cannot be a hindrance in the locker room. Mom and dad won't stop fighting. Dude, you're going to tell me a point guard, De'Aaron Fox isn't even top five. What? Luka Doncic is a better point guard than De'Aaron Fox right now.
Take this.
That's a power forward. God damn it. He's just one shot. Oh my god, he turned at the perfect time. All Curry does is shoot. He's garbage. Oh my god. Oh boy, here we go. Is this the highlight I'm looking for? Sure is. Oh shit.
Nope.
There we go.
James trying to harass Curry. Curry off the dribble. Layup off the glass.
He just beat LeBron James off the dribble in an ISO play, split him down the middle against Kevin Love, And you're gonna tell me all he does is shoot? He's a better finisher than I didn't transition, did I? I didn't transition. Oops. Just make sure it's up. Okay.
James trying to harass Curry. Curry off the dribble. Layup off the
Look at this. Look at this. Zero screens. LeBron is like 35. Oh my God.
James trying to harass Curry. Curry off the dribble. Layup off the glass.
If you say he's a better finisher than Wall and Fox, you're high. He is. He's not a better dunker. He's a much better finisher. Wall's faster, and Wall's a better passer and defender. But Curry can strip better. Curry can get by you. Curry can get by you in a half-court setting. Wall's going to blow by you. That's the difference. Curry's known for his three-point shot, but he can finish. He's one of the best finishers in the entire league. And he can strip you. He's going to pull up in your mouth from anywhere, not just three-point. He'll pull up from anywhere. Let's look at another thing where he, Curry, shot over Chris Paul. Where's the one right here? This is not just three-point shots. This is dribbling and creating your own shot. Look at David Lee's old ass, dude. Look at this. This is on the baseline. That's awareness to know where you're not going to go out of bounds with a ref right there, so he's not going to miss it. He breaks his defender, one of the best defenders in the league at the time, for a point guard. Do I get to pick what parent I live with? No. Chris Paul was one of the better defenders in the league as a point guard at the time. Destroys him. Pulls up from about 13, 14 feet. John Wall's not doing that. John Wall's not going to do that. Wrong. He is the best point guard in the league right now because he makes his team better. He defers. Did you see Chris just slip? Yeah, it's called breaking the... Oh my God. Yeah, because Curry dribbled. And dribbled. Curry didn't break him. What do you mean? Curry redirected him back this way. So Paul tried. It's called freaking nutmegging someone. Nutmegging is where you go underneath the legs. Curry redirected him back towards the basket. So Chris Paul tried to shift his weight. And he couldn't shift fast enough. So his feet went out from under him. That's literally what happened. He didn't slip. In the sense that he just slipped over some sweat. Are you out of your mind? He starts falling the second Curry redirects. See? Right here. He's trying to change his momentum because he sees Curry trying to go this way. His feet are still planted. And then he tries to redirect. He slips off of this foot. That's textbook ankle breaking. Right there. That is how you break an ankle. You can't tell me he didn't just slip. Are you out of your mind? Curry is the best point guard in the league right now. Right now, Curry is the best point guard in the league. He makes his team better. He defers to his teammates. He doesn't stat pad. He knows when to take over. When he planted, he slipped. Yeah, because he planted, because he saw Curry going the other way. Oh my God, you played basketball. You know this shit. You know this shit. Come on now. Don't play me. I know my shit, but I know you know your shit. Come on now. Be smarter. Also, Curry didn't ruin the league. Other teams trying to mimic him, a la the Houston Rockets. I forgot to see if ninja runs are what ruined the league. You want to know what team wins when you shoot more threes than the Warriors? The Warriors. Because they take good shots. They don't just chalk up threes. Two records were broken last night. Most 3-point shots attempted in a game, and most 3-point shots made in a game. And the Warriors won one game, and Houston lost the other. We can agree to disagree about Curry, because you're wrong! Come on, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. Oh, man. I'll debate basketball all day. Dude, I'll rebuy 2K right now just so I can have a basketball stream. I'll do it. No one here either. There's nothing but heartless in this castle. About him being the best, I don't think he is, and you do. Voice! I know you're watching, so explain this. Where are the people from my memories? Do you want to see them? Of course I do. But you cast them aside. What? You dreamt of the outside world, and you passed through the door to darkness. Behind you, you left family, friends, home, everything. All in pursuit of darkness. But I cast that aside, too. And what do you have to show for it? First, your home, then the dark. Your heart only knows how to cast away. It's empty, like that room. There are some books in there, like your memories. That's why you don't meet anyone. Your heart is hollow, except for the residual darkness. No, hollows are in Bleach, which is my favorite anime. You're wrong, I rejected the darkness. Ha ha ha, did you really now? Continues to run away from his problems. If I could talk, it would be easier. Fucking get a PC. We'll game, and we'll talk about this. And you'll lose the argument. Wow, Bleach trash show. Dude, Bleach is my favorite anime, okay? Did you see Marluxia use his Bankai last night? Because I sure did. And I was reminded swiftly of how good of a swordsman Ichigo Kurosaki is. Oh yeah, I forgot. Like it? Best shooting guard? I mean, it's James Harden. He's playing like a point guard, but he's listed as a two guard, so. Nobody's doing what he's doing. And you like trash? That's. What you talking about, Barutos? What? Oh, you're saying it's a trash show. I haven't watched Boruto. Naruto wasn't very good. I think Naruto Shippuden's alright. You know what I've been watching lately? With M'Lady that's very, very good, is Attack on Titan. I'm kind of late to that train, but I really enjoy it. I hate Harden, but I agree small forward. It's still LeBron. It's still LeBron. All the way. Until LeBron doesn't go to a finals, it's LeBron. Also, anything past season one is trash. Attack on Titan? I just got to the trial. That's as far as we've got. Yeah, bro. Yeah, we just got to the trial. And, yeah. Power forward and center. Power forward, it's Davis, probably. Gonna be Luka Doncic in about 2 years. If he's still playing four. I don't know if they're gonna have him play four forever. I think he's more of a two guard or a... I think he's a tall two. Or a small three. Because he can handle the ball so well. So how can you have him down as a four? But anyways, I think right now it's still Davis. That's center? Man, that's a tough one. DeAndre, oh, he's a power forward, ain't he? Luka is going to be a two or three. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Well, they play him like a... They play him in the guard spot. That's what I'm saying. He's officially listed as a... Like on the All-Star ballot, which is what he is on the roster, they have him listed as a power forward. Best center. Man. I mean, it's got to be Jokic. Is anybody doing what Jokic is doing right now? Jokic is making a case for MVP. Nikola Jokic. I can't think of anybody else doing what he's doing. Be right back. Okay, man, we'll be here. Did I just name all Western Conference players? What did I say? I said Curry. Oh, I have a boss card? What did I say? Curry, Harden, LeBron. Yeah, I named all Western Conference players. What's this do? Protect. Yeah, I mean, who's better than any of those guys in the East? Maybe after this season. Oh, shit. Maybe after this season, Giannis might be better than LeBron. As well, LeBron's 35, ain't he? Is he 34 or 35? So, like right now is when he's going to start slowing down. I think his groin injury is going to really fuck him up. I don't think people are talking about that enough. And Kyrie's kind of hit his ceiling. Kawhi's kind of hit his ceiling. Giannis is only going to get better. What else do we got? I think... Oh, God. Oh, man. If Giannis gets a mid-range in a three-point game... The most dominant. I don't think he needs a three-point game. I think that he's that good. He's like LeBron. LeBron didn't need a three-point game until 2 years ago. I think Giannis is so good he doesn't need one. I think he needs to be more aggressive. I think he needs to be like a James Harden type where he's just getting fouled every single possession. That's what I think he should turn into. But I do agree with the mid-range. I super agree with the mid-range. 100%, I agree with the mid-range. But I think he's a type of player who will be just fine without a three-pointer. I think he'll be just fine. I knew you would return, Riku. Maleficent, you're alive. You haven't been paying attention. I am but a figment of your memory. Of all the people I could run into, it had to be you. But of course, after all, your heart is steeped in darkness. You can only see those who exist in that same darkness. No. Be grateful you have someone to keep you company. Your heart is empty. Oh, Embiid, that's right. Were it not for the darkness it contained, you would be completely alone. That's sounding pretty good right about now. good comeback. Come now, you once turned to me to sate your hunger for darkness. You want me here. Who but I can grant you the darkness you long for? There was a time I did want you around. I surrendered my heart to the dark, but never again. You and your darkness have nothing to offer. Were you looking to walk? All I did was lose myself. Empty myself. I'm finished with all that. If I'm stuck seeing people like you, people of the dark, I'll take you out one by one. Then you must forget to destroy yourself, Lass, for like me, you are one of the dark. That's fine with me. I turned to darkness because my heart was weak. I hate that weakness. It's like my own enemy. And seeing people like you embrace the darkness just make it worse. Enough talk, Maleficent. So you hate the dark, darkness enough to fight it. Oh, the agony you must feel. Then let me end your pain, Riku. End it forever with the wondrous power of darkness. What happened to your boy, Dame Lillard? He's hit his ceiling. Kristaps is predominant as well. Exactly, though. He can't stay healthy. He's like Joel Embiid. He can't stay healthy. Embiid can stay healthy now. Yeah. What does Protect even do? This is a lot easier than the Sora fight. Ow. No! Get on it!
Take this! Like it!
Like it? One more. What? He's using cards that are stronger. No, dude! There we go. Woohoo! I can only do basketball. That's the only one I know well enough to like keep a conversation going for so long enough. I haven't barely watched any football this year. And then, Dragon Maleficent. More like Maleficant, am I right? Yeah. Wait, why is my fucking... It's not working! Hey, there it is, alright. Yeah, basketball is the only one I really know enough to talk a lot of. Where am I supposed to go? Oh, I see. But I think Kristaps is overrated. He cannot stay healthy. He can't. What's this do? Riku cannot customize his card deck. Guys, this deck will change as Riku advances through the game. Thanks. I just want to know what this boss deck is. Increases damage received, sacrifices reload speed to power up attack cards. That's pretty cool. I'll teach you my ways. Of what? Football? It's a conscious choice not to watch football. I hate everything about football except the players. I hate the commentators. I hate Roger fucking Goodell. I hate how it's ran. It's a joke. I like hockey, but I don't watch it. I watch highlights. Baseball, it's hard for me to get into a baseball game that doesn't have...
Why do you shun the darkness?
Tigers in it.
Come on, I know you heard me. Every word I said to Maleficent.
Darkness is your weapon. It is time you learned you must accept it.
What do you mean?
Stop resisting.
Stop resisting.
Accept the darkness. You have no choice.
He's got a gun!
If you are to serve me again...
It's Ansem.
I thought it was you, Ansem.
Oh, you don't seem surprised.
All you have been talking about is the darkness. I can only assume you want to pull me back in so you can play Puppet Master.
Clever boy. I knew you'd be the one to most appropriately serve me. And now, surrender to me again.
You're crazy! Not a chance!
Oh, damn!
Did you really think you could do me harm? A weakling like you couldn't even defeat Sora, and you had darkness on your side.
Excuse me for being weak.
You are weak. You need darkness. Surrender. Bow to darkness. Bow to me.
That's not gonna happen.
Only the darkness can offer to you all of the strength that you will need.
You're wrong.
It's him, dude.
That voice.
It's him.
Your Majesty?
That's right. Remember, Riku, you're not alone.
Wait, we don't get to see him?
Listen close. The light will never give up on you. You'll always find it, even in the deepest darkness.
I got it.
That's like a different voice actor than his other games.
I won't lose to darkness. Not today.
Like noticeably different.
You think that feeble light can save you from the darkness that I command?
Let's go, bitch. I've beaten you so many times, it's like a freaking roulette wheel at this point. How do you want it this time?
You shall feel the darkness everywhere.
Jeter and what he did to the Marlins? Yeah, did he have a personal grudge against Florida or something? I'm curious. Give me all you've got, I'll give it right back. Like, Jesus Christ. Chose this card, break it right away. I know. Oh, well, I'm trying to. Whoa, what was that? Rapid break, quickie break. Oh, man. No fucking way. Oops. Quickie break
the opponent's card for a boost in attack.
I can't believe it. Oh my god. Is that fucking real?
Not giving up yet. I wonder how much of this you can take. I'm just going along until you give up.
Show the same value card as the opponent's. Is it that funny? Dude, this is a AAA studio and they misspelled quickly as quickie. Yeah, it is that funny. It's a AAA studio. Show the same value card as the opponent's and press triangle. I am. Okay. Press triangle?
Just me.
Break all the opponent's cards?
Get a load of this.
Oh shit, that's pretty cool. That's awesome, I like that. Show the same value cards as the opponents and press triangle to start. Break all the enemy's cards to execute a slate. But you'll need more than 8 cards? I just wanted to cue, Kawhi.
That all you got?
Ayaya.
It seems to me that you are intent on resisting the darkness. All right, then see it for yourself. This is a card crafted from your memory. Advance through the world it creates, and soon you will understand. Chasing after light is not the way. It will not give you distance from the darkness. There is no running from the...
Not only did they misspell as a AAA studio, but this is a remaster. So in the remaster, they didn't fix it. After completely re-editing this entire game to have fully fleshed out cutscenes and a completely new combat system, they still didn't correct it. Yeah, it is that funny. Darkness. Oh my god.
Don't Quickie. Worry, I'm not running. Give it. I'll enter the world, and in the end, if I haven't given in to the darkness, then I win.
I have one more gift for you.
What'd you do?
I simply tempered the darkness that yet remains in your heart.
You still think that I'd rely on darkness?
To use it or not is your choice.
Fuck yeah.
I'll be waiting, Riku. For you to sense it and yield to the darkness in your heart.
Hell yes. Riku learns D mode. Dark mode can be activated when you have accumulated maximum dark points through card breaks. Your skills are powered up. You have more slates to choose from. DP is lost when your card is broken or you receive damage. Do I get my cool little suit when I do it? Hey, Lamau. Let's go in reverse of how we did last time. Oh man, it's him. And him. Big sword guy.
Don't I even warrant a hello, Lexius?
What is going on here, Zaxian? I want an explanation.
Nice to see you too, Vexen. It's such a shame. The organization used to be the rope that bound us together.
You're only number six. How dare you?
Let it go, Vexen.
Brr, look at that chin.
Zaxian, tell us. What did you detect?
I like his fucking voice actor.
Visitors. I picked up two scents in the castle's lowest basement. One of them was Maleficent.
Don't be absurd. The witch is gone. She cannot return from the realm of darkness of her own volition.
If you would let me finish. The scent belonged not to the real Maleficent, but to a very convincing double. But I truly cannot say much beyond that, since the double is no more. Our other visitor saw to that.
And who is it?
I do not know for sure. But the scent was very similar to that of the superior.
And yet, not exactly the same, was it? This truly piques my curiosity.
Now, what to do?
We wait. See what develops.
Sign reminds me of a Gears of War character.
Something smells funny. What's that scent? It's so familiar.
Darkness. Oh my god, it is.
It's the smell of darkness. I can't believe this is happening. The darkness even seeped into my skin.
Don't worry, Riku. Your Majesty.
That's the stupidest fucking thing I've ever heard. Do we get to see his model? Yes. Oh, no, it's a ghost.
Oh. What happened? I can see right through you.
What's that smell? Darkness.
Funny, huh? I can only send a bit of my power to this place. That's why I've got a request for you.
Request?
Listen, Riku. Just because darkness holds you, don't let go of who you are. You've got to fight the darkness inside you. It won't be easy to do, I know. But please don't forget, even in the darkest darkness, there's always a little bit of light.
Light within darkness?
Yeah.
You and I have seen it. The far welcoming light inside the door to darkness. The light of Kingdom Hearts. It will show you the way.
Voice actor.
Please don't give up. Believe in the light. That's a request from my heart.
Okay. I'll do my best.
Trust me. I'll try to find a way to reach you. I'll get there. I promise.
His voice actor in Kingdom Hearts 2 is so much better.
You're an illusion.
Don't worry. We shook hands in our hearts, remember? We're connected, you and me.
Guess we are.
Peace. Okay. Oh, man. That was great. What's that smell? Darkness. Again, I think back to Chappelle's Show. I've been binging that lately, by the way. That's why it just keeps popping fucking up in my head. Darkness. Alright, so we gotta go in reverse. So, I think I did Neverland last? The voice actor for Mickey was like, are you sure this is what you want me to read? Well, the original one died, I think. The voice actor in Kingdom Hearts 2 died. But because in fucking Redux, or Recoded, or whatever it's called, it's a different voice actor. It's like noticeably different, too. It's very noticeably different. Like it? What's Mickey even do? Ow. Nope. Nice! That's sick. Do I, can I? No, I have to match it. Uh-oh. Well. Yeah. Too slow. Burr. And I don't have a fork. I want to keep doing this. Come on. What? Oh man, you gotta go quick. Nice try.
Take this.
How do I do it? Pressing all my fucking buttons, bro. I pressed it! Oh my god. Oh, I see. I just have to... Dark Brick. What? Oh. That's pretty cool. You just weared them? Oh, fuck yeah. Raises DP, dude. Nice. Ow. Do it. Somebody attack.
Take this. Like it.
Like it. Come on. Ow, fuck, shit, cock, stop it.
Take this.
What's this guy do? All zeros? That seems really bad. Oh, okay. I see. Ah. Or I'd like the card game. I don't know the card game. What card game are you referring to? Oh, like war? Like the card game war? I never won a game of war. Feels bad. Oh, you can use different moves when you do that. That's cool.
Darkness!
He's so cool, dude. Oh, you don't get to keep it. That's so sad. No, stop. I like Riku. I like that they added some semblance of strategy with that fucking mechanic, though. It's just luck. Now, if you count. Ow. You get D point really quickly with that. Yeah.
Take this.
D point.
Like it. Take this. Your Majesty.
Heal me. Thank you. Oh.
Like it.
Cool. What reason do I have to go and play Sora again? I don't think there's a secret boss. So, like, why should I? Why? But why? Let's do... This one. Hog, dude. Bear-na-na-na-na-na-na. No, I was really hoping that would hit. Do it again.
Take this. Darkness.
Darkness. Ow. What a...
Your Majesty.
MM Miracle. You gotta tap that really quickly. Did they change Atlas to an early access game? It already was. They just didn't advertise it as one. Like the trailer didn't have it as an early access, but the store page did. That's why people were so mad. Fallout 76 should have never came out. You fucking bitch. Ow. 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 Stop it. This slate sucks. That slate was actually trash.
Take this.
Fuck. Okay. Yeah, you're not gonna do anything? That's fine. Dude, I never, like... Atlas is just... Wowzers. What a freaking catastrophe. I never had any faith in Ark, though, so... I'm not gonna say I saw it coming. There was no way they were gonna live up to that trailer. Plain and simple, they just weren't. Oh, shit. You're gonna tell me. That anyone with a sense of. Shoot, fucking bitch. Anyone smart enough to know the developers of Ark. Looks at that trailer. You know people that love Ark? Are they okay? That's so fucking annoying. That only happens on zeros. See that? It only happens on zeros. God damn it. Fuck you! Nice, dude. Really happy you did that. Ark is such a crap game. It's really bad. The concept is fucking awesome. Concept is great. But the execution is some of the worst fucking execution I've ever seen in a video game. That order fucks me up so bad. The engine's terrible. The servers are terrible. But man, that concept is so good. That concept is masterclass. Don't go underground. I mean, dinosaurs are just cool, right? But you have a company that already has like kind of a shady history. Say that they have a game. Deck. Where you can have 1,000 play, what was it? A 1,000 or 10,000 player lobbies. Only one game has ever been able to do that, and it's called PlanetSide. And WoW, like even WoW has servers, right? You just look at that, and you gotta question it. Like how? How are they doing this? Summit. What? Yo, you play Sea of Thieves? No. That was another game. Probably really good now. I haven't watched any of Summit playing it, but I bet it's really good now. That was another game where they fucking overpromised everything that they were doing. This is a waste of time. Inverse burst? Oh shit, that's fucking awesome. Hell yeah. You had a company that overpromised everything. But the scramble to get things, it's like No Man's Sky. No Man's Sky was supposed to be this revolutionary experience in gaming. And what it turned out to be, a waste of time. Stop it. I pressed the button. A waste of time.
Your Majesty, come on. Time's
up. Holy shit.
Your Majesty, come on. Time's up.
That spell's so cool. Or that slate, rather. It was shit at first, but probably pretty good. Haven't watched anyone play in a while. I haven't played it either in a while. Sea of Thieves is rare. Yeah, rare. That's the only thing they had going for it, is their company. You also gotta, like... A game like Fallout... Oh, shit. A game like Fallout 76 was never gonna work. Because half of their marketing material was talking about players doing the work for them. Like, I remember one of the biggest marketing campaigns when they were at like a conference. They were saying, like, I think Angry Joe had this. I've never played a Fallout. You can play 3 in New Vegas and you're good. It was that damn John Denver. it got everyone, dude. But they were at like a conference, and I think Angry Joe had this in his video. Nice! the guy's talking about, like,
Take this.
I don't have any cards. Uh-oh.
Get a load of this.
The guy's talking about, like, saying, if you want to be the best steak maker in the wastelands, then you can do that. And, you really think a player base is gonna, A, want to do that? And take the time? You think anyone wants to go, hey, you've been playing Fallout 76? Yeah, man, I make the best steaks in the game. Like, nobody wants to do that. Nobody. And it was ridiculous of them to think that that was a good idea. A multiplayer Fallout would be fantastic, but the problem is they've been using that same engine for about 10 years now. They do that in MMOs. Exactly. Well, no, MMOs is different because no one is just the best steak maker, you know what I mean? That's what they were saying in Fallout. Oh, I'm gonna go to this guy for the best steaks. No. You also want to be, like, a support character is one thing. They're, like, talking, like, about, like, vocation and stuff like that. Which is fucking insane.
Take this.
I should have saved that. No. Vocations as a concept is cool, but they gotta be done right. No one wants to say, my primary, unless you're doing an RP server, which, sure. But nobody in a Fallout game, you really think that would have worked? No. Do you know what people like doing in Fallout? They like using vats and they like killing things. That's it. That's Fallout. Not making stakes. No siree. Listen, man, I applaud them for trying. It was all RP. It's if they wanted to do RP, then just release the game and support fan-made servers. Just like how Arma did. Arma makes, and GTA, to give GTA some credit, GTA allows there to be GTA Online RP along with Arma. Arma's RP spawned a whole fucking community. That's the right move. Let the fans create it. Create the game. But don't base... if the creators of Arma said, we're going to do an RP type game next. Or GTA... Instead of going the direction of the game that has been working for years and years and years, like, what's the reception there? On a tired server? Shit.
Darkness!
You like the story of 76? Story of 76 or the story of, like, Fallout in general? Because they fucking, they retcon so many things in 76. The Brotherhood of Steel got butchered in 76.
Take this.
Absolutely butchered. Nice. I don't know, I guess just do whatever your users want. Yeah. Let's get an even 200. There are games that do... Why am I even busting those? I'm looking for, like, red dots still. Like, look, Bethesda has been... You gonna get the Division 2? Probably not. I mean, Fallout in general. Yeah, Fallout. The Fallout story is awesome. It's fantastic. But then they butchered it in 76. But, like, look at Bethesda as a company and how they've been treating their consumers. They got rid of modding. You have to use a third party now to get mods. They reintroduced modding, but you have to pay for it now. You have to pay per mod, which they said is an excuse to pay the modder. But really, it's just an excuse for them to monetize a free service when you could donate to the mods, and most people did. If a mod was good, most people would donate or crowdsource it. And all the money would then go to them. Or a game like City Skylines, where they take mods and they reintroduce them as DLC. So A, it becomes official. And B, it officially becomes a profit for the creator. You can still get it for free, and they allow you to get it for free. But you can then support the company. They give you the option to support the company and the creator. And in that, highlight modding and stuff. Because they say right on their DLC page, this is a mod, fan-created mod. That's how you do it. You don't take that away and then reintroduce it without the option. Which is exactly what Bethesda's done. Bethesda's become very anti-consumer in the past, like, few years. And they started with fucking Elder Scrolls. How many Elder Scrolls have they released? Oh, what the fuck? Oh, okay. I guess we're doing it. Sure. Okay. I'm gonna duel him right off the bat. Oh, wait. I forgot I can't duel him. Ow. Darkness! Do it! Okay. Any stun, Pog? Bye. Easy peasy. Yeah, Todd Howard fucked everybody. Todd Howard fucked everyone. And he did it with a fucking smile on his face. Do you remember the conference when they announced 76 and he's like, this engine has new lighting, new sound design, blah, blah, blah. It's a complete rework. It's... They are in a rut, man. And then, oh, man, the debacle with how they released the collector's edition with the bags. Holy shit, holy shit. where is Champions Respite? Probably right there. I'm gonna get the Division 2. He just likes fucking people? Yeah. Am I gonna get the Division 2? I don't know. I don't know. I'm gonna wait. The past couple Tom Clancy games, the open world ones have always intrigued me. But what was the big ass one? Tom Clancy's Wildlands or something like that? Ghostlands or fucking something? I don't know. That game looked awesome. But then they release it and it's kind of empty. And then Division, same thing. Division looked awesome. And then they release it and it's kind of empty. So, I mean, again, if they've learned their lesson, yeah, I would love to get the Division. because it looks fucking sweet. Wildlands was okay, but I do miss the vision. I almost bought Wildlands a lot of times. Oh, what's he do now? Second heal? Okay. Ow! Darkness! This is awesome. Ow. I will not get the division because I felt burned on the first division. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Same thing with... I fucking pre-ordered the collector's edition of Destiny. And holy shit, have I ever been cucked so hard in my life with Destiny. And I haven't even touched Destiny 2. And with State of Decay 2?
Take this.
Yeah, I love State of Decay. Oh, you bitch. I played the fuck out of the first State of Decay.
Take this.
But yeah, I heard State of Decay 2 was really bad.
Your Majesty, come on.
Time's up.
Ah, I see.
Like it?
Darkness. What?
Darkness.
Yeah, I don't know what happened with there. You gotta tap that shit quickly, man. Holy god. Stop it. Yeah, pretty much tap it right as you're hitting him. I had a max level character in the first one, but it just got boring. It's State of Decay. I just loved, like, I loved the world of State of Decay. It was, like, I wasn't a big zombie guy, but for me, it was the first zombie game that I was like, this is the evolution of the series, right here. This is it. We've made it.
Out of my way.
Nice. And then, yeah, I guess they dropped the ball on two. Oh, Division. Okay. Yeah, see, I never played the Division. I wanted to, but I heard really, really bad things, so I stayed away from it. Ow. Now I have a four. You got one of these.
Your Majesty, come on.
Do it. Nice. That refreshes your cards too. That's really good. Day's gone. You just take forever to read chat. It's I'm 20 seconds behind because I'm not an affiliate or a partner. I don't know when you get that ability. What I'm doing is 20 seconds. There's a 20 second delay. So. Yeah. I think that's what Doc has it at. Or does he have his at 10 seconds? Days Gone releasing on PS4 looks dope. Yeah, I've seen a little bit of that game. I'm just like, why zombies? Why? Why? Like, are they really gonna sell? Where the fuck am I going? That is the way I'm going. God damn it. He has a million people talking to him. Yeah, well, 30 million, give or take. Just me.
Get a hold of this.
I'm always looking. it's the new fad since The Walking Dead. There's nothing new about it. Walking Dead's been around since like 2008. When did Walking Dead start? They're in their what, like 8th season?
Like it?
It's just, it feels tired to me. What was the zombie game that was like, took place on an island that people really liked for about a week? Oh my god, what was it? There's nothing, exactly. Ah, oops. Just me.
Out of my way.
Diddle-little-little-little-loo. Eh.
Like it.
Ow, no.
Your Majesty, come on.
Get him.
Hey. Nice. Zombie Island? Was it literally called Zombie Island? Was it actually? No, it's called Dead Island. Right? Dead Island? I don't know. Dead Rising was boring. I think Dead Rising 1 sucked. I think Dead Rising 2 sucked. I think Dead Rising 3 was great. I think Dead Rising 3 was when they finally figured it out. They just ramped up the ridiculousness. Yeah. Dead Island, yep. Boom, boom, boom. I knew it was dead something. You get points equal to that, like, that you break it with. I didn't get Dead Rising 3. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Because we played it together. You have it on Steam. I know for a fact you got it. Don't lie to me. Yes, you did, dude. We played it together. I can show you that we played it together. You're lying. No way. I promise you. Go look right now. In fact, I'll look for you. I'll do it for you. Let me go here. Games. Dead Rising 3. It's the only game in my library. Who do you vote bitch about? That's all I remember about that game. Who do you voto bitch about? My computer is broke. So here's my Dead Rising. There, right there. 5 hours. Let's go to, believe it. Let's go to your account. Where the fuck you at? Is this you? No, it's not you. Where are you? There you are. View profile. Doxing the poor lad. I'm not even doxing him. It's his same name that's in the thing. Also, I was right. You played H1? When did you play H1? Oh, dude, let's talk about H1Z1. The greatest BR ever made. Holy shit, do I miss H1Z1. I miss the fuck out of H1Z1. No, let's not talk about H1. Why not? I thought I played it on console. No, because I remember we played it together, because I really enjoyed it, because I was watching Uber Hacker Nova play it. And I was like, this game looks fun. And it was for 5 hours. And then it's like you're doing the same thing over and over and over. It just wasn't for me. But I think that's when they made the formula great. H1 is awesome. How many players do you think H1 has on it right now? I know how many. I want to know how many you think it is. Just take a guess. Fuck. What am I doing? I don't need to collect these. Just go. 1,000? It's about 800. It peaks at 1,000. It's very lucky to peak at 1,000. On a very, very good day. When Summit was replaying it, it was peaking at 1,000. Oh, man. Those were the good old days, dude. Right now, H1Z1 has exactly... Not loading. 913 people playing. In a game with 100 people servers, it has 913 people playing. Oh, man. I miss the shit out of H1, dude. I miss it so much. I miss it. I do. Ooh, but here's the thing. The creators of H1, Daybreak Games, they are developing the BR for Planetside, which does have 1,000 people servers. That's the downside of BR, is they need so many active players to get good games. Yeah. But I think that's what makes them great. But anyways, Planetside, I'm sorry for hitting my mic, by the way. Planetside 2 is coming out with a BR in like the last week of January. And Daybreak is developing that, which is they're who developed H1. So, you know, we're going to see how it is. It's going to be 500v500 BRs. I've never even heard of Planetside. It's a niche game, but it's PC exclusive. Has 1,000 people battles. It's awesome. Anime
I have
gasp.
Identified the scent. It is Riku.
Darkness.
Riku, you say? Has he emerged from the realm of darkness?
His existence, it was once doubled in the darkness.
Fascinating. That's why you mistook him for the superior. The dark power given to Riku facilitated his escape from its realm.
What I want to know is why he appeared here in Castle Oblivion.
That's really quite simple. His existence resonates with that of another hero.
Sora is in the castle?
He arrived earlier. Marluxia is already using Naminé's unique powers to meddle with Sora's heart.
Without even bothering to consult us.
It seems he desperately wants the Keyblade Master for himself. What a foolish plan indeed. Sora's is not such an interesting existence. The entity that holds true value is Riku, the hero of darkness.
Oh no. You can play Planetside on PlayStation? How? How the fuck can a console support that many players? How? I don't understand. I feel like your PlayStation would just blow up after that. Your Astros are only good for Xbox. Get Corsair Void Pros, dude. Or HyperX's. Or Audio Technica. Oh man. I love my Corsairs. I don't like the mesh padding. I had the leather padding that my headphones previously had. But I really like the mic. Mic sounds really good. I've listened to myself back, and it sounds really, really nice. And obviously, the RGB is really cool. Like, I have a Corsair. I have the Corsair K90 keyboard. I have a ST100 for my stand. I have Vengeance RGB RAM and my Void headset. So I all have it synced up to the same thing. And oh boy, is it pretty. It's pretty. Oh man, Moon streaming Dark Souls. He's doing the mod for Daughters of Ashe. That's pretty neat. J- jerk it to your own voice? I don't know about that. I have a lisp. I can't. I notice it when I listen to myself back. It pisses me off. Too bad we can't see it. The Void Pro. I thought about getting the plugin. For, by the way, I will never stream with a face cam. Ever. I will never have a face cam. I hate it. Uh-oh. Oh, we got some of them. I don't like it. I think it gets in the way of the game. Which is what I care about. There's only one guy. Ow. I think that was a fucking waste. Of a Logitech G613. I saw that as at Best Buy. I almost bought that because I love the sound of it. But just listen to this, dude. Like, am I going to hit anything? Hold on. Oh man, it's fucking brown switches. Yes! Okay. Oh, it's so good. But yeah, I will never stream with a face cam. Ever. Ever, ever, ever.
Take this.
Even if I get... Oh, by the way, oh my god, I was so hoping you guys were gonna watch the stream. Were any of you on Twitch earlier today? At about like 3-4 o'clock.
Take this.
Any of you. Hello. I don't have a 3. Why don't you attack me, goddammit? Uh oh. I was at school, yes. Did you see how many viewers Ninja had not playing Fortnite by chance? Just curious. He was playing Final Fantasy 14. He was on the front page of Twitch. And how many viewers do you think he had? If you didn't see it, how many viewers do you think he had playing Final Fantasy 14?
Oh, man.
It tickles me.
$5,000,
yep. $39,000, not even close. He had $5.5K viewers playing a game that's not Fortnite. Is he live right now? Fortnite. He's not. Tfue is. Yeah, he had 5.5K viewers playing Final Fantasy as opposed to Fortnite. 5.5K. That might be. You are on fire, dude. I didn't think you were gonna get it. That was a great guess. That's the Wheel of Fortune guess too. You didn't go over. How are you, like, that might be the starkest contrast in viewers a streamer has. It's got to be, right?
Just me. Get a load of this.
Oh, shit. I didn't know it freaking grabbed him like that. Like, what are you doing to lose that many viewers? That's insane. That's the biggest drop-off game to game I've ever seen. Ever. Like from an average, like from your average viewership. I've seen people like their average viewership is pretty low and then they go play a different game and it freaking shoots up. I've never seen, I don't keep track of Michigan Native Ninja. I forget he's from Michigan, dude. He's a little fucking Lions fan. He lives in Chicago now. I read that fucking ESPN story on him. I do think, I will say this, his wife is a Packers fan. His wife is not a nice lady. But What was I saying? Where's my fucking four? I can't find cards fast enough. I want a duel. There we go. Oh, shit. Okay. Maelstrom. That was kind of a letdown.
Like it. Take this.
Nice. He was born in Detroit? Yeah, that's right. That was Moon. Moon was born in Michigan. What was I gonna say though? Yeah, he lives right outside Chicago now. Listen, Ninja's done a lot for this type of business and legitimizing it and whatnot, but man, do something. It's just so easy to rag on him. No way then he became a Florida boy. It's because his dad was in the military. How long you been watching him? Hey man. Were you watching him when he still played Overwatch? Curious. 2-2-2-2-2-2. I don't have a 2. I have a 4. I didn't grab them together like the other one did. Ow. I started watching him. He lived in Jacksonville. That was still pretty early on. He moved up to frickin' NC. Okay. I was just curious. He's my favorite streamer. I like knowing these things. Nice, very good.
Darkness!
Bet that's really, really good for like a boss, but it's just trash right now. I think Doc is the best. I think Doc has the best broadcast. But man, Moon just fucking brings it, dude.
Take this.
Okay, I think he was just meant to do it. Or at least something in this vein.
Darkness!
Darkness! Fucking move sucks. It's like a shotgun. It sucks. His other move's better. The one where he freaking shoots up in the air and it just stabs him from up top. It's so much better. Let's do this, I suppose. Yeah, I bet that move's really, really good against a boss, but wow, it's trash against mobs. Jesus Christ.
Take this. Darkness.
Nice try.
Your Majesty. Come on.
Time's up.
Hit that one. No, dude. Like that move right there, it's so much better. Oh wait. I want to see what this card does. Absorbs enemy HP. What? That's so good. That's really, really good. Dude, Rika's overpowered as shit. He's overpowered, dude.
Like it. Your Majesty. Come on.
Time's up.
Yeah. Do it. Oh, man.
Take this.
darkness!
That's a little too high. Yeah. Oh, he climbed the ladder, dude. What a god. Climbing the ladder. All right. I just go fight the boss right now. I'm ready. Yeah. How close am I to leveling up? Oh, very close. We'll fight one more guy. Where am I going? Oh, he's down the fucking hall. He doesn't run like a ninja. That's so sad. Yeah. I just did, like, the ninja thing with me is, like, I don't think, I should rephrase this, I just, he's a good guy, and he has been grinding forever, I think he was the sixth person to be partnered on Twitch, like, overall. Like, it was Summit, it was, Soda, fucking, Goldie.
Like it. Darkness.
Injo's up there, Dan's Gaming, obviously. So, like, I don't... In my opinion, he deserves all the success in the world. Yeah, he's someone who's been doing it for a very long time. But I think that there are better faces of what Twitch is. Because Twitch is a lot more than Fortnite. That's what a lot of people see it as, I feel like. At least in the mainstream crowd. Right. That's my main gripe. And also the fact that he kind of bitch and moans every time he starts, like, his top spot starts to get threatened. Every single time. He will... Like booby streamers. No, you know who I think is a good representative of Twitch is Tim the Tatman. I think Tim is a perfect representation of Twitch. He's someone who's, again, he's been around since the beginning. He's played and has been good at multiple games. He's what the fuck? What's going on here? He's always good. If you say one more nice thing about Tim, I'll die. Do you not like Tim? Do you not like Tim? I don't watch him anymore. That's solely because I don't like Fortnite.
Take this. Like it.
Like it? Do you not like Tim the Tatman? You just compliment him too much? He deserves it. He deserves it.
Take this. Like it.
He silently grinds, man.
Darkness.
And you never hear anything bad about him. He's never complained or been upset that he's, like, not the most watched. He'll say it in, like, a joking manner, right? Every once in a while. But it's very obviously like a meme. He's not like... He's not playing a character, which I don't have a problem with. But, like, you just know that's him on screen, right? He's a family man. He's, like I said, he's just, he's great, I think, for the community. He's so good. I'm out. I'll catch you guys tomorrow, 5 to 7. Nope, I got a game tomorrow. Tomorrow will be a late stream, so probably like 11, 12. What the fuck? Oh, by the way, we got rid of our all-star rookie. He signed with a, he got called, it's weird. He got an AHL contract, which is the league above us, with a different team that's not Utica. Maybe Saturday. I also have a game Saturday. So, oh, I heard you. Same time Saturday. Sunday for sure. Sunday we'll do a long stream probably. Get you coming. What the fuck was that? Depending on, because I work both my jobs tomorrow, depending on when I get out for my first one, I might do another like PUBG stream. I really enjoyed that. It was short and sweet. We got a victory. We almost got another one, but then I choked. I was hitting some nice shots that last game, though. That sniper shot on the guy laying down. Oh man, that was pretty. You gotta admit. I fucking messed up my AK spray though on that last guy. What I should have done. I completely forgot my vest was super low. What I should have done was played him at a distance. Yeah. I won't work Monday. That's perfect. All right, peace. Have a good rest of your stream. You hit me up on Discord. Let me know if you get on early. Will do, man. And starting next week, too, I'm going to start putting my schedule underneath. What am I fucking hearing right now? Okay. So there's no confusion. I think the week after my birthday, I have entirely off, so, which is not this coming Sunday, but the next one. How do I be your Discord friend? Message me your thing. I'll add you. Hey, send me a Twitch DM, and then I'll find you right now. Don't put it in chat though, just send me a fucking DM.
Like it.
Yeah.
Take this. Like it.
Stop it. Hey man.
Take this! Your Majesty! Come on! Time's up!
I will say this. His slates are super boring. This mechanic's cool.
Darkness.
I love this mechanic. But the slates themselves are really... Oops. The slates themselves are super, super boring. Alright, let's get this shit a-rollin'. Where the fuck did it go? Oh, there it is.
Installing, ensuring the dankest means.
Is that your, is that your server, or is that your actual, like, code? Shit. Bake a bake a booga bake a cake. What? And now you can't be lazy. A bit of boob dabity do.
Streamer mode is enabled. Add a friend.
Your Discord tag. Boom. There you go.
It's on Twitch right now. StarCraft 2. Holy shit. Why? Oh my god, Tim's playing Overwatch. Oh, I'm gonna watch that later. That's so exciting. I was actually gonna play Overwatch when I'm done with Kingdom Hearts. I was gonna make a fucking grand return. That's so exciting.
Come on.
Come on.
Get a load of this.
I need that to be just a little bit bigger. Yeah. That, like, circle of death.
Like it.
That's a ton of damage.
Yeah. Ha. Take this.
Brand-new, 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 brand-new. Come on, please.
Of the Rhine main. I was actually thinking I was gonna do my my DPS ult. I miss playing Genji. I really don't. I necessarily don't really miss playing Rhine. I was a very good Rhine main, but I noticed after playing fucking Dive for a year and a half, I was a very bad Rhine main. I was a very good Winston at the end of that. That's what pushed me to Master and GM, was Dive. I didn't get Master until Dive. Oops. I just heal people. Who do you play? Mostly. Like, who would you say is your best character right now? First of all, when's the last time you played? And then what's your best character, do you think? Mine still Winston, without a doubt. I could play Overwatch right now and probably just pick up and go with Winston last week. Oh, see, I haven't played in that long. Or, it's been much longer since I've played. Let's see. Please be fire. Last time I played Overwatch, it was at the beginning of last summer. Right when Overwatch League was in its like fourth season was the last time I played. Whenever that was. Whatever season that was. Or no, I'm sorry. It was right when, I didn't play comp, but it was right when, Hammond got released. I just love healing and getting yelled at by DPS mains. Aw, dude. You would love playing with me then. I don't take that fucking bullshit. Can I duel this guy? Oh, shit.
Like
Yeah. Do something. Nice. Oh my god, it's so easy. That's my life. Don't take that shit, bro. One of my favorite, like, memories playing Overwatch is, I was playing, Zenyatta. Every time someone sends me bad messages after a game, I would give them a compliment. I've never gotten messages after a game. You can't send them on Blizzard, can you? On VNet? Or do you play on console? I've never played console Overwatch. Yeah, not gonna walk all the way fucking back. I've had people try to friend request me after a game, after they were like super toxic, and then I just don't do it because I know exactly what I'm gonna start hearing in my fucking headset, and I don't want to deal with that shit. I'm 23. I'm about to be 24. I'm not gonna sit there and listen to that. Yeah. What's this guy do? But one of my fondest memories playing Overwatch was there. I was playing Zenyatta as our only healer. Console dab. I've only had a PC for like 3 weeks. Oh, okay. Well, dude, let's play fucking Overwatch together after Kingdom Hearts. I would love to. I was mainly a solo queue player because I wanted to see. I like seeing how I work in those like pressure moments.
Like it.
The game gets super easy when you play with people, so I like seeing how I do on my own.
Darkness.
But let's fucking play together, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh shit, there's so much more.
Your Majesty, come on.
Time's up.
Kill him. No, it's so close.
Yeah,
I never played on console, so I don't know what it's like. But I was playing Zenyatta as the only healer. And like I said, healing was something I very, very rarely did. The only reason I didn't the only reason why I did it was because there's a player on my team who had like 2,000 hours on Ryan. So I was like, that's usually the only time I would defer, is when you had a ton of hours on the hero I wanted to play. That's typically the only time I would defer. And so I did, but I turned into the only healer. So I said, hey guys, I'm fine with healing, but I'm not gonna main heal. I'll do literally anything else but main heal. Even though I really enjoyed Anna, I really, really like Anna. She's the only main healer who I enjoy playing. I was like, listen, I'm not gonna main heal. I'm already switching off something I want to do. I'll deeps, I'll tank, I'll off tank, I'll do anything else, but I am not gonna main heal. So we didn't get a main healer. We had three tanks and two DPS and then me. Which sometimes works if you have a main healer, but I wasn't gonna do it. So always nullifies the enemy card. Interesting. So it went about as well as you thought it would. But then the Ryan, who I let, because I picked Ryan first, because I have a fantastic internet connection. Not to brag, sorry if it comes across that way, but I have a really good internet connection. So I usually get in matches before other people do. So I picked Ryan first, and I'll always go through everything and figure out what works best for my team. And I should have been Anna with that comp. No, I wasn't going to, because I'd already made that sacrifice, and everyone else had already made their picks. But I told the guy,
I was like, listen, man, I'll let you play Ryan, because he had 2,000 hours on him. But I'm not going to main heal. I hear him say, okay, that's cool. But then no one else picks a main heal. But then I start hearing it from him. Once we go in, this was on Hanamura. I'll go into it after this. Hold on.
I take it you're Riku. Are you with Ansem? You are half correct. Let us say that he is not the Ansem with which you are familiar. He is Ansem, and he is not Ansem. Perhaps a nobody best conveys the idea.
Riddles were never my thing. Try again.
He belongs to neither the light nor the dark, but walks the twilight between.
Oh.
Catching on now? Oh, yes. You also stand in between the light and the darkness. It appears we have much in common.
Maybe. Like you said, there really is darkness left inside of me. But so what? Darkness is my enemy.
Yeah.
And so are you for reeking of that awful smell.
Oh my god.
Oh, so it's a fight you want. Very good. I shall take you on.
This is gonna blow. This is gonna suck. But anyways. Yeah, this guy, once we go on to defense on Hanamura, starts yelling at me. Hey man, you never do something.
Taste this! Just me.
I have a 9! Oh, I did. Shit. Alright, fine, bitch.
No good. Like it.
Oh my god, this is gonna fucking blow. I'm gonna lose. Nice.
Yeah. Like it.
Oh, that did no damage.
Take this. Here you go. Like it. Taste darkness.
Here we go. Where the fuck is Mickey? There he is.
Yeah.
I gotta pay attention to this. Nice. Oh shit. Dark aura. Oh, it's this move. Hey, bitch. Ow, ow.
You imbecile.
Oh no. Ow, ow, ow. Stop it. Get him! Oh no. What am I doing? Got him. Oh no. Now I do. Woohoo! Just win the duels? Yeah. I picked it up halfway. I had to focus though, because he doesn't have any heals. That's the challenge. He has no cures. So that's where the challenge comes in. But yeah, this guy starts yelling at me. Hold on.
I find coursing through you, there is a darkness of formidable power growing. Well worth the trouble of aggravating you. All this excitement has provided me with invaluable data.
What?
Many thanks, Riku.
It was a trick all along.
'Twas merely a trick of the light. Any more fucking cutscenes, or can I tell my goddamn story? Like the JPEGs on that sword? Yeah, all three of them. So yeah, this guy starts yelling at me. Now keep in mind, I'm a Zenyatta, he's a Ryan. And I am the lone healer. I'm being stubborn, I understand that. I understand that. But in my mind, I had already made the compromise. So now it's my team's turn to make the compromise. This guy starts yelling at me. He's like, dude, you never put an orb on me. And I'm like, I was like, I wasn't annoyed at that point, but I'm like, listen, man, I am the only healer. When I swapped off of your hero to let you have it, so you gotta let me heal everybody else. I always have my orb on you when it's defaulted, but if there's someone with less health, which was most of the team at that time, I'm gonna put my orb on them. Unless they go find a health pack like my deeps. And he's like, that's bullshit. You should swap. I'm like, no. I'm not. No. A, he was like the gatekeeper to fucking Diamond at that point. I think I was like 3,300. I was like, dude. It's called compromising. Like, holy shit, what's this guy do? Back attack.
Take this. Your Majesty. Come on. Time's up.
It's really not that hard. Someone else go main healer.
Darkness.
And I'll do whatever the fuck you want me to do. But I'm not. I already swapped off of what I wanted to do. And wouldn't you know it, we lost that round. But I didn't put my orb on him the rest of that match. I think he made it reasonable enough, if it happened like you said. I was a little bit more bitchy. But no, it's literally how it was. When I was on my main account, I'm super reasonable. When I'm on my DPS account, I don't give a shit. Which is funny, because my DPS account placed higher. But, I would like to see what it would place now. But, what was I saying? Yeah, when I'm on my main account, I'm super, super reasonable, because I'm playing to win. On my main. As most people are.
Like it? Your Majesty!
It's just, oh man.
Take this.
I do. I miss the shit out of Overwatch. I truly do. I truly, truly do. But the moral of that story is, in a game like Overwatch, you can't let fucking people walk over you, because they will.
Take this.
I really hope they introduce hero bans. God, I hope they introduce hero bans. I know they're talking about doing it for tournaments. Jayne did a bunch of hero ban tournaments, and they worked as well as you think they would. Amazingly. It's crazy to me in a game like that that you don't have hero bans. I would have to buy the game again if I bought it for PC. Oh, okay. I understand. But, yeah. How do you not have hero bans in a hero-based shooter? How? Get him! Aw, man. It's nuts to me. Especially in tournament play. In tournament play, in a game with heroes, you need hero bans. Plain and simple, you need them. You need hero bans.
Like it? Take this.
I think they should do double bans. I think they should. Each team should get to ban two heroes and one map. Just like in CS. Each team gets two map bans and one map choice.
Take this.
Or one lock, rather. Because that's the argument I always see from people on Cal. They're like, there's not enough heroes for hero bans. You won't be able to see the best players on their best hero. Well, if the best players can only play one hero well, are they really the best player? And then also, you have CS, which I think is the best esports game right now, with like 7 to 8 maps in active rotation. And they do it all the time. Every tournament they have map bans. Every single tournament they have map bans. And it works. It works really, really well because it adds another layer of strategy. And you have it in amateur tournaments. And you have it in just regular matchmaking. Not to the same degree, you don't get the teams and then go through a map ban, but you can say, I don't want to play this map. I don't want to play this map. Boom. Overwatch should be free to play by now. It plays like a free to play. I agree with that, because they make their money through cosmetics. 100% I agree with that. I think they should lock competitive behind a paywall. A very, very low paywall, like $5 or $10. Or even make it like a fucking subscription fee. Doesn't goddamn Dota have a subscription fee? One of the most successful games of all time. Or is it League that has a subscription fee? And it works. It's insane to me how fucking stupid Blizzard Activision has become. I miss Overwatch is one of my most beloved games of all time. I fucking love Overwatch. I love it. I quit playing that game because A, the community, and B, because the choices that were being made with new hero releases. I didn't like the release schedule. I didn't like the direction of heroes that were going. The only good heroes, I think, were the DPS heroes. Orisa's always been pretty bad. Doomfist was good for like a month. I don't know the meta on console, so I can't speak for that. But Anna was good again for like the first little bit that she was released, and then they nerfed her into the ground. Moira's not very good. You would think Moira would be fantastic in GOATs. You think that would be where she shines, and she didn't. She doesn't do enough. Brigitte has been just a joke of a character. They have finally... I still like Moira. She's not used in top play, though. I like her, too. I loved playing Moira. The problem with Moira was that she was a low-tier hero. Which was the direction they were going. They got away from the FPS-type heroes, which is what people want. That's why people like Ashe so much, which, again, even though she's not really used... People like her because she is that. People love Anna because she's an FPS hero. The problem becomes when you have someone like Mercy, who is very low skill, but her ROI is absolutely insane. Same with D.Va. D.Va's low skill. A lot of the tanks are low skill. Being a tank main is easy. But, I mean, the only way you could see a bunch of heroes in top lane would be hero banned. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. That's exactly what I'm saying. Oh, you bitch. Who are you going to heal? Exactly. Most amateur pugs have hero bans because it adds strategy. It thins out the talent pool. When I pause it, by the way, I talk with my hands. I'm like Italian. It thins out the talent pool. which is what you want, right? You want the best of the best playing with the best of the best. It makes the games so much more diverse and interesting. And I truly, truly don't know why they don't want to do it. If you only had a face cam, I know. I'll never get one. I will never get a face cam. Ever. It takes away from the gaming experience. It takes it away. When I go to Twitch, I go to watch games and gamers. I'll watch them rise up. I don't want to look at some mug. I think if it's done well, it adds a lot. Like Doc does it really well. That's what Moon said, and look at him. No, Moon said he was embarrassed of his office. That's why he got a face cam. He has an office now that he's proud of.
Like it.
He never said it took away from the game.
Take this.
Come on.
Yeah.
I think the same thing. Like, Moon, during Darkest Dungeon, he had no clue where to put his face cam.
Like it.
Like it.
Your Majesty. Time's up.
He also started streaming when he still lived at his parents' house.
Take this.
Which would, that would stop me from having a face cam too.
Darkness.
Honestly.
Yeah.
Dude, he used to stream with a closed mic. Can you imagine that?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
He should be embarrassed of his hairline. Ow, I pressed the button.
Yeah.
Yeah, can you imagine streaming with a closed mic? I would go insane. I would just straight up forget. I would forget I closed my mic. I would have no fucking idea I closed my mic. I've done it before. And I'm sure once it becomes like habit or whatever you learn, but Jesus Christ. What a fucking pain in the ass. Stream with a closed mic. But I understood it, you know what I mean? And he got rewarded for it, right? Nice fucking throw. Come on up. The water's fine. But yeah.
Take this.
I fundamentally disagree with face cams.
Like it. Take this.
And also just like it, I mean, I keep saying the same exact thing. It just takes away from the game. Like, who cares what I'm looking at when I'm playing this? Who cares? Nobody. I'm sure I've had some great reaction faces. But I don't want to take away from a game like this. So these are my favorite game series of all time. I don't want to de-highlight that. You know what I mean? I also think streaming with a face cam is lazier. You'll be like Lyric or Beru. I love Admiral Beru. I've only just recently got into him. I love him though.
Come on. Get a load of this.
Yeah. Yeah, like, it can be done. You know what I mean?
Like it.
Oh, I thought I killed them all. Yeah, I just recently got into Beru. Because I saw him streaming KH. I was like, fuck yeah, bro. I don't know why I'm still doing this. There we go. It's my door. Ow.
Just me.
Just me. Here I go.
Out of my way!
Yeah. Oh no. Oops.
Like it.
When do you attack?
Darkness.
There we go. Lyric is one of the biggest streamers. I know. Lyric doesn't hide his face though. Like Moon hid his face for the longest time. Cryotic. I haven't watched Cryotic since his YouTube days. Yeah. Dude, the amount of damage that you do over that is crazy. That's crazy! Yeah, Lyric's a legend. And he's never that's the thing that's funny about Lyric to me, he's never talked about, ever. And he's been like the biggest guy forever. I can't remember when Lyric wasn't the top guy.
Take this.
That was it? Are you serious? I'm not gonna level up from this fight. Let's just go. Let's go fight. Let's actually heal first.
Take this.
Like it?
Take this.
Oh, I didn't pick up the balls. No, dude. Shit. Please have balls. Okay. He's floating away. It's fine. Just a blue card. Any blue card? Any blue card at all? I think I do just fine without a face cam. I think I do just fine. Oh, fuck. This fight sucks. It's gonna suck even more with Riku. Can I duel him? See if I can duel him. I don't have an 8! Ah! Yeah, I don't even have an 8 in my deck. You fucking asshole.
Take this.
We'll see what happens if I duel him. Shit. I think I used the 5 in my slate. Very nice. 0. No, dude. Do something. Oh, fuck. Come on. I'm glad this doesn't have a time limit on it. Oh, shit. What the fuck? Oh my god, is this real fucking life? There we go. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Oh my, I wanna fucking die. Jesus Christ almighty. Just got that one off. I can't reach him. Nope. Ah!
Your Majesty, come on!
Do it, bitch. What is he resisting? I want to die. It's not hard. It's just annoying. Oh my god. It's
not hard, it's annoying. There's a difference. Dark? No, I kept missing. And I don't know the slate for Dark Fireaga, so... wouldn't have worked anyways. Nice smirk, dude. It's all the ladies with that. How many fanfictions do you think there are? Where is Conqueror's Respite? Which one do you think it is? I bet it's that one. I bet there's so many. Well, you beat him. At what cost, though? That was fucking boring. Oh, that sucked. I hate that fight. I hate that fight in Kingdom Hearts 1. I hate that fight in Sora's Chain of Memories. But the Ursula one's gonna be just as bad. Ow.
Darkness!
The problem with that move is that he kept moving and you don't move with it, so like bleh. More than should ever exist, the fanbase for this game is the worst to ever exist. No, it's not. You know what fanbase sucks? Doki Doki Literature Club. A fantastic game ruined by its fans and its subreddit.
Take this.
Because the developer of that game made it as a parody to the dating sim.
Take this.
And then the fans of that game were like, I really miss dating sims. I blame Hot Topic. Dude, I go to Hot Topic so often still. I still go to Hot Topic a lot. They have my Funko Pops. They have cool vinyls, because my girlfriend and I both get vinyls now. At least our mall one does. Ow, you fucking asshole.
Take this.
And of course the Funko Pops.
Darkness!
Darkness! I think I hate you. No, you bitch. You fucking asshole. Don't hate the player, man. Hate the game. Oh, man, you fucking cunt. I don't like any of those things. Not a one. What don't you like about vinyl?
It's the most pure way to listen to music nowadays. Excuse me.
Like it?
Take this.
Anyone who doesn't listen to a vinyl really hasn't experienced true musical bliss.
Let me tell you this. It's really not that different. Take it from someone who has a record player. It's not that different. It's not. Take it from someone who is a musician, has a film degree, minored in audio design. It's different. There is a noticeable difference. But it's not nothing to frickin' come over.
Darkness.
Absolutely not. I'm not sitting there looking at my vinyl records going, oh god, yeah, oh, I'm getting the best audio quality over everybody. Oh god, the compression on Spotify sucks. Oh god. No. I'm gonna pay my fucking 14 bucks a month or whatever the hell it is. Listen to music I never would have heard of ever in my entire life listening to vinyl. That's what Spotify does. And also listen to it in the car or on my computer. It's great. The vinyl record's cool. It's a good aesthetic thing. And I can listen to Tool, which isn't on any digital service. But I'm not gonna fellatiate myself over the fact that I have a record player. Anyone who deserves to be fucking slapped. Because holy shit, you're a menace to society.
Your Majesty! Come on!
Time's up!
Yeah,
Like it!
I don't want to go. Ah, you fucking asshole! I don't want to waste the time going. You're a collector, I suppose. I collect Funko Pops.
Like it.
I have a spreadsheet. That's how deep into it I get. Of the franchises that I want.
Take this.
That's really about it, though. I don't have a two, dude. I don't have a two. I have a three.
Just me.
Uh-oh. I'm going to lose. I have no nines or eights. Oh, there's an eight. Get up, Riku. For me, Funko Pops add a lot to my desk. Like, on my desk right now. Fuck. I collect very expensive cardboard, that's it. Kill him! Murder! Let's see. Oh, and I collect, like, if there's a game series. Oh, I collect Blu-rays, but that's like, Blu-rays are a practical thing to collect because you can use those, you know what I mean? Like, I have, like, over 250 Blu-rays, but we watch them, you know what I mean? That's the difference. So, on my desk right now, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 Funko Pops. And I got a lot of Kingdom Hearts 1, I have a couple anime ones. And then I got a bunch of Overwatch ones. You use the cardboard? Okay, dude. Sure you do. Sure you do, bud. Wait, should I level up? How close am I? Where do I see that? Status? Nah, we're fine.
Take this.
Give me that sweet green orbs. Yeah, give it to me. They add a lot to my desk. Plus, some of them are really cool. Like, the Riku one's really nice. I have a couple Full Metal Alchemist ones that just got released. I have an exclusive Toy Story Sora one. I have this is either a GameStop or a Hot Topic exclusive, but, like, the Sombra one where she's, like, in her purple form, whatever the fuck it's called. I have that one. It's cool. I enjoy it. Oh, no boss fight. All right. Moving along.
What's happening to Sora?
Naminé's powers are being used to shuffle his memories as we speak. Marluxia may well succeed in getting his puppet. Sora would be a valuable asset to the organization. But Marluxia and Loxene's actions, they leave me quite uneasy.
And then there is Axel. Who knows what that one is thinking?
Vexen should take care of this. His replica is soon to be completed.
But Vexen despises Marluxia. Think of the mess it would make.
So we must tell him. Isn't it better that Vexen clean up the mess than leave it to us?
Oh no. You don't like the design of Funko Pop? Yeah, I get that. That's the main argument I hear against him. We don't need to save again. There's no boss fight. Keep on rolling. I think, I will say this though. I think whoever, like, if they do teams per, like, franchise or however they do it, I think the designs of them have gotten much, much better this past 2 years, as opposed to, like, early Funko Pops. I think now they're really, really good. And even, like, the paint job on some of them, like early on was fucking terrible. It was just straight up bad. Like, oh god, which one is it? I have one where the paint on it is just really bad. I think it's an Overwatch one. But, yeah, they've definitely improved over the past little bit. I'm happy for you. I'm happy for you, man.
Like it.
I'm happy that you're happy.
Take this.
How's college going? Are you almost done? Shit, you're the same age as me. Did you start late? Wow, thanks. No problem, man.
Like it. Take this.
Get him! Aw, man. No! There we go. I graduate this year? Where are you going? I think when I left our hometown, I think you were going to Mott, weren't you? Are you still going there, or you go somewhere else? That fucking shitty-ass school. I have so many gripes with Mott, dude. Oh my god, that's another stream in and of itself. Yeah, but I'll have a bachelor's degree if I go to Un of M Flint. Are you going to?
Like it.
I know a ton of people who go there. I know a ton of people who go to U of M Flint. They all like it.
Like it.
They're all like medical degrees.
Take this.
I graduate. Oh, I see. Okay.
Your Majesty. Come on.
Time's up.
It's fine there. They did not do well by me. Not one bit.
Yeah.
They, my counselor fucked up my. My credits. God damn it. Kill him, please. No. Yeah, my counselor fucked up my credits. My professor, who led the department, screwed me over a couple of times. When did you graduate? What year is it right now? I graduated in 2017. Summer 2017, because I messed up my credits. So I thought I would be done summer previous, 2016. But I didn't start my program till spring of 2014. So I went a whole year thinking I had graduated. And then I went to, because the job I was applying for went to ask for my degree. And I was like, yeah, okay, no problem. Let me get it for you. So I went to Mott. I was like, hey, I need a physical copy of my degree, please. And they're like, okay, hold on. Oh, it says you still need a... I do have 2 degrees. I have a gen ed and a media degree, but a mate degree. But they're like, oh, it says you still need 12 credit hours. I'm like, excuse me? So it turns out, because the mate program changed when I was there, and no one told me. I was told by my professor that, like, my class was fine. That, like, we wouldn't have to change our program or however you want to call it, like, our program path. Turns out that somehow my information was not passed along that pipeline. So I indeed had to change, like, program needs. So I had to do 2 internships and another class. And that's why I talk about how I had to drive that commute for so long. Because I moved out to Kalamazoo thinking I had a job. But yeah, it didn't work out that way. mean, it's fine now, right? But, I want to fucking die. I'm getting too fancy with it. That's the problem. I'm not. No, I refuse to hang up my Mott degrees. I also don't think they're that, like, special. I could have gotten my job without ever going to college. Plain and simple. For me, college was a waste of time. I will never say college is a waste of time for other people. I'll just tell them my experience and say, yep, for me it was a complete and total waste of time, and now I will be in debt for about 30 years, because that's my plan. Hey, I earned them. Your degree is a good degree. You know what I mean? Your degree is a very good degree. But no, mine is never seeing the light of day. I didn't hit this guy once. Yeah, CIS. Oh yeah, it's yep, for me. Personally, for me, it was a waste of time. Is it for other people? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. But for me, it was a waste of time and money. Now I'm just, I'm making good money. I'm making good money in the sense that I have enough to live comfortably, right? Yeah. Why does he do that sometimes and not other times? I don't make enough money where I can just be like, I don't want to have my debt anymore. And just pay it off, you know what I mean? So, it's just sitting there. I mean, it's not sitting there. I'm paying it off every month, but it's just fucking racking up interest. Every goddamn month I get to see. Every fucking month. Yeah. Thought the guy spawned here. No! I also have no loans when I graduate? Yeah, see. That's crazy to me. Like, that concept of no loans. Because even my girlfriend, she's learning to be an occupational therapist. She's gotten a ton of grants, a ton of scholarships. And she's going to be multiple tens of thousands of dollars in debt. She was a great student in high school. She's a great student now. School's still giving her money, and she's still going to be in debt. Had that rich grandpa. Did you?
Like it. Take this.
Yeah, not us. It's all fine. I mean, it is what it is, right? I can't go back in fucking time and be like, be rich. It's, or don't go to college. Yeah, he made Mold Master. Oh shit, did he? I didn't know that. I had no fucking clue. Let's do this. Do they need someone to do a commercial for him? I'll do it. I'll whore myself out. But yeah. It is what it is.
Like it.
Like it.
Take this.
Nice fucking whiff, bro.
Like it. Come on.
Uh-oh, this is bad. Yeah. No, I was spamming it.
Your Majesty, come on.
Time's up.
That's so slow, or so short.
Take this.
I think a parts shop needs a commercial. Hey, man. My other job is fucking making commercials for a parts shop. who I'm contracted to. Carlton Equipment. I am their media and commercial guy. My technical position. My technical assistant is media assistant. Because they couldn't justify hiring one guy full time for a for something that they could contract out to. So my buddy, who's a salesman there, and also runs their website, he kind of got me in there. Cause I was freelancing out to them prior to that. Sound like Jeff pouring himself out, but he got that rich girlfriend. Who, Jeff Simeon? There's a name I haven't heard of in a long ass time. Hey, both of you group up.
Darkness!
Darkness! Oh, what a fucking waste. Yeah? Holy shit, really? What's that girl's name? Like Ashley or something? Yeah, I haven't talked to that guy in forever. I don't even know what he's fucking doing right now. That whole crew back in the day, I haven't kept up with a lot of them just because I don't have, like, Facebook or anything like that. Don't know, he moved to Chicago last summer. Oh, really? Huh. Riri. Like, I keep up with, the walkers a little bit. Chain's fucking bigger than a house right now. Your Majesty! What?
Darkness!
Yes. Who else do I keep up with? Ian, I keep up with just through his fucking tweets. Isabel Fahim, I keep up with. She's a photographer now, so, like, we all watch each other's work and whatnot. Do something cool. Nice. Do it again. Chain worked with me for a long time at the Kroger. Oh, that's right, he did, didn't he? Dude, fucking everyone got employed at that Kroger. Everybody. Seems like every fucking time I walked in there, there's just like three of you guys. Goddamn Sean worked there, Shane. The other Shane worked there too, I forgot his last name. He had a big head. Derek worked there. That's somebody. Yeah, that's somebody who I haven't thought of in a long time either. Derek Evans, holy shit. I miss that kid. Die! Aw. Is he still with that Asian chick? What's her name? Shane Richter, yep. That's what it is. Derek Evans, man. I'd love to reconnect with him. No? Really? That sucks. Dude, they were together like all of high school. Holy shit. I'd love to reconnect with him. He was a funny guy. Derek has a nice white girl now. Oh my god. Oh man. He has a nice white girl now. Who do you sound like? Sound like OJ. Oh, she a white girl. Oh man. Is he still in Lapeer? Die! Woohoo!
Ha, ha,
Give me that fat level up, baby. There it is. The Asian girl's name is Amber. Yep, that's right. You are right. It's been so long, man. It's been so long. Zero? Boom. Let's fight this boss. He lives wherever he lives. He never let me come over to his house. I never went to his house either, but if he's still, I'm just curious if he's still in the same town. Fuck this boss, dude. There's like five of them. Can I duel his ass?
Come on.
Oh man. This deck sucks. No, don't do it! I'm gonna do it the old-fashioned way. Ow, ow, ow.
Take this.
Almost. What?
Darkness!
Darkness! Ow. Uh-oh. Do it!
Yeah!
Okay. Yeah, no, it's fine. Ow. 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 Am I out of cards? When did that happen? Uh-oh. Uh-oh. That's not good. My cards, dude. Take that. Take that. Yeah. Take that. And that. And that. Oh my god. If I slate that. Okay. It doesn't matter. This is fucking stupid. Oh my god. Darkness! Oh my god, I still only have one card. Give me Mickey. Nice. Take that. This is fucking stupid. Oh my god! This is the stupidest fucking thing I've ever done in this game! What the fuck, man? He blocked it. What a god. I'm just dead now. Yeah, there's nothing I can do. Ow! What?! Ow, fuck. No, I can't do my super dodge anymore. Take that. And that. One more. What? I win. That was the stupidest fucking boss fight on the planet. Oh my god. What a waste of time, dude. Did he change what he was going for? He's gonna get his masters this year and he changed what he's going for? Holy shit. What a fucking waste, dude. What happened to all my cards? Did I have like three cards in my deck? I feel like they went away really quickly. Guard armor. Guard armor. Who am I gonna fight next? Is it gonna be big tough guy or, Yeah, how many cards are in this? There's only 18 cards. Holy shit. Is there a special place I should go? No, it's gonna be this one. Let's mother... Oh, we can't. Oh, yeah, we can. Let's heal. Before we have to go fight Mr. Boss Man. Oh my god, that was awesome. I loved every second of that. Nice fucking swing. Oh my god. I should have done this world first, I think. Yep, I was right. I forgot it healed over here. That's fine. I couldn't imagine doing a master's program and changing what you're going for. That's nuts to me. I'm not that smart. That's why I'm a fucking media kid. I smoked way too much weed when I was first starting college. Like, copious amounts of weed. Who do we fight?
Huh? What are you supposed to be?
Is it Repliku?
Surprised? I guess you should be.
Yep.
After all, I look just like you.
Like that Spider-Man meme.
I'm an exact replica of you that Vexen made from your data. So you're a fake me. Not a fake. I don't care if you're real. You're not better. We share the same body and the same talents. But there is one easy way to tell us apart, though.
Anime pointing.
Unlike you, I fear nothing. Are you calling me a coward? You're afraid of the dark. The darkness inside you still frightens you, no matter what you say. But I'm different. I embrace the darkness. I can make it do whatever I want.
Boss music.
So, I can wipe the floor with you.
Nice! Riku versus Repliku. They're also gonna make Data Sora a character in fucking Kingdom Hearts 3. I wanna die. Nice try.
Take this.
Oh.
Darkness.
Stop it. Stop it. What the fuck? I'm forgetting which one I am.
Take this. Darkness.
No, I wanted the heal. Yeah, take that, bitch. Yeah. Do it, I dare you. Do it. Uh-oh. This is bad. This is really bad. No, don't. God damn it. Fuck. I halfway through that battle, I completely lost track of who I was. I only do that now that it's legal. Legal. I actually haven't done. I haven't smoked since it's been legal. Interesting enough. I mean, I've never smoked before. Because it was legal before, and now it is legal. I just haven't done it. Yep. Do it again. One more time.
Yeah.
No. Uh-oh.
Your Majesty! Come on!
Heal me, bitch. Thank you.
Take this.
Got him.
How can I lose to
Yay! You just gotta spam. That's it. I forgot. You lose your D points if you get hurt.
Yay!
Just fucking spam and you win the game. That's Riku.
Hey, fake! I thought I heard you say you were gonna wipe the floor with me.
Dude, nice. Throw it right back at him.
Don't forget, I'm still new. I'll get stronger and stronger. The next time we fight, you're finished. Then let's fight now!
Yeah, agreed.
What the fuck?
It's nice having darkness on my side.
It's a bladed fucking weapon.
You are so missing out. How could you be scared of something that can be so thrilling? Enough! So now the coward is playing tough. So long, real thing. Hope you don't miss me.
He's still running away.
Come back!
Dude. Riku just tried to straight up fucking murder that guy.
No way. I'm not a coward.
Not a coward. I'm not. Got him. Yeah, dude. I'm not a coward. Look at that smirk.
So, how was the real thing?
He's spineless. In no time at all, I'll be better than him.
In the meantime, would you be interested in meeting another who's considered a hero?
You mean Sora. I hear he's somewhere in the castle. You want me to take care of him?
We'll see. Yes. I intend to make good use of you.
No worries. The real Riku is nothing. Sora won't be either. They're no match for me.
Stomped him into oblivion.
Come out! Show yourself, fake!
Fake? Oh no. That's not exactly the right word.
Look at that smirk.
What are you saying? Isn't he just a copy of me?
More like a model. He is an example of what you should try to be. He accepts the darkness. Just like you once couldn't help but accept me. But now you are afraid. Perhaps you are the one who is being fake. Fake when you pretend to have no fear.
When have I been afraid of the dark?
Inside of the card worlds, you grappled desperately with the darkness. Desperation is fear. You fight the darkness because it is what frightens you.
Be quiet!
Ooh, he landed on his feet this time.
Stubborn boy. Then continue your fight if you must. Eventually, you will learn. You cannot resist the darkness.
Where does he go? He's got nowhere to go. I completely wiped out everything. Like that, everything about him has been wiped out. So where does he go? Where? Challenge from the inn. Okay. I'm done. Dude, we're kind of blazing through this. We should be able to beat it tomorrow night. I'm going to stream pretty long because I don't have to get up early Saturday morning. So we're going to stream pretty late into Friday night. Yeah, man, if we did five worlds in 3 hours, we got to get through seven. So, yeah, we'll be fine. If I do a 4-hour or 5-hour stream, tomorrow. We'll beat this, and then we'll be ready for Kingdom Hearts 2 on Saturday.
Yay! We're getting there, dude. We're getting there.
Peace.